What's going on, party people? Yeah. I don't know what that was. Anyway, it's another members only request. Shout out to T Smith for making this Q&A possible. Y'all ain't playing. But how are we gonna get into this? I'm glad that y'all, you know, of course I read all the comments, but I'm glad y'all enjoying these types of videos. Say thank you to the members. Yeah, these are all the members. But yeah, say thank you to them for making videos like this possible. Monday and Fridays, those are vlogs. Anything in between is whatever is what it is. But Monday and Fridays, those are vlogs. You'll always, or it's always gonna be there, but anything else in between, hey, thank the members. Go ham in the comments, say, keep doing your thing, members. Anyway, Lord, let's go. We got 10 questions. It is morning time, 8:53 Friday. Work's about to start. Well, it's already, I'm already in it, but I'm like, yo, let's do this. So I'm a little, yeah. Wake and bake, it's gonna be interesting. Yeah, all right. Can you recall a time in your life where someone made you feel inferior? Inferior means lower in rank, status, or quality. No. This is something I learned late in life. And this is why, yeah, I'm very, you know, people, you know, I've come across certain people in life that, you know, when you talk about how words have meaning, it's like, shut the fuck up. Words have meaning. Because no one, the person, I've never been made to feel inferior. Let me take that back. People don't make us feel. People be who they are, and it's how we react to what it is that they're giving. So, like, it's something a little lighter than this. It's not gonna call me stupid. If I'm at a place where I'm not feeling good about myself, I'm gonna take that in, and I'm gonna feel stupid. When really I know I ain't stupid, but the place I'm in and where this person said what they said, it's got me in a place where I ain't good at the moment, so I take that in and I make it personal. That ain't that person, it's how I received it. Yeah, so has anyone ever made me feel inferior? No, but I have, and what I just said, there you go. So, nah. Hope that answered the question, yeah. Name something that's priceless to you. I've said it many times before and it won't change. Peace. 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 I'm not a rah-rah person. And for those who've been watching me for years, those of you who know me in real life, no, I am not a rah-rah person, and I can't handle it too well because I go from 1 to 1,000 real quick. And lately, I've seen that as I've gotten older, like, and now at this present, I realize I can't. Yeah, I need peace because I see how it affects me emotionally, mentally, and physically. Ooh, excuse me. And yeah, so. Hopefully that answers your question. Peace. And I always say, the peace that I have with myself, whomever I get around, I need to continuously still have that peace. If I'm around people that I see that affecting that, I gotta get away. Sometimes it may take me a while to wake up, but I gotta go because I see the imbalance in my life. Hopefully I answered the question. Is there anything you consider to be unforgivable? Yeah, I'm gonna do it. Gonna be little to no editing up in this thing. So bad as to be unable. Fuck, using the same. Okay. Inexcusable, unpardonable, unjustifiable, indefensible. I don't think I would say they're unforgivable. I don't know, that word, it just seems, because I'm looking, okay, it gives the adjective, it's an adjective, it says, so bad as to be unable to be forgiven or excused. Well, actually, no, yeah, there are things that, because using this, thinking again, yeah, there are things that are, so is there anything you consider? Oh, I gotta pick one. Well, okay, in the current space that I'm in, what it's always been is liars. It's unforgivable. Lying. I'm a big girl. Tell me what the fuck it is. Be real. It may hurt my feelings, but guess what? I'll get over it. I'd rather, you know, it's just, unforgivable. Yeah. Like, you know, again, speaking from where I am, you know, what this chick did, it's unforgivable. You know, don't steal from me. Don't. That on top. Would you try to protect your reputation, or is what other people believe about you none of your business? I'll take the second half of 1,000. What other people believe about me is none of my business. What the fuck you want to believe? Like, for me, like at work, or it doesn't have to be at work, it could be anywhere. You could be meeting me for the first time. You would think like, oh God, she mean. Oh, she unapproachable. She don't want to talk. Okay, if that's what you want to feel just by that, cool. And you don't talk to me and never get past that, that's on you. Because I hear a lot of stuff and I'll be laughing because the people that know me and that we cool, they be like, I ain't like that. But the thing is, I just don't fuck with everybody. And everybody ain't friend. I don't do it. So, like, with that, and I'm using most because it's like, you know, as a, you know, again, talking from where I'm at now, that's what mostly where I hear or deal with things like that. So, it's funny to me. And I'm not trying to go to them, those people, and say, oh, no, I'm like this. No, believe what you want to believe. How I deal with you is the energy I'm getting. I just don't fuck with everybody. So, how you feel? Ain't none of my business. Next. In dating, is right now or the right one and more important to you? I think I've been doing it wrong. I don't know if I need to start doing it right now. Because, girl, shit. Oh, my God. The right one is important to me. And I don't want to say the right. I don't want to like that. The right one. But just for the sake of the question, I'm going to go with how you worded it. For me, it's always been the right one. But I'm, you know, I'm working on a balance for me. Because that's my problem. Thinking about the potential and not thinking about right now what this person is showing me. I'm thinking, oh, this person, oh, no, fuck that. So, for your question, it was right one. But I'm trying to get to the right now, be in the middle of the right one and right now. I'm finding that balance because, yeah, that shit ain't working for me. What is the most toxic personality trait in your opinion? Personality is what I was thinking of, like personality. And I couldn't think of how to word it. So I'm just going to maybe give an example and maybe it'll explain what I'm thinking. And I, you know, and now I'm thinking about the question. I want to relate it to myself. I discovered that I had a toxic personality trait like at the end of last year coming into it. And it was, I don't know the word for it. Maybe you could put it down below. But I'm just explaining it. Putting people on a pedestal. With the value that I have for them. I don't know if that makes sense to you. I don't know. But yeah, that was, yeah. And that's, I think that's the most, that's, girl, don't do it. Don't do it. But I learned real quick and I'm good. That don't exist no more because it's like, do you know who you are? Do you know, I'm talking to myself. Do you know who you are? Girl, yeah. So I think that's toxic. Putting people above you or before you. Yeah. If you know the name of that, put it down below. I don't know. That's what, yeah, that. And I'm putting it towards me because, yeah. Yeah. Two-part question. Have you ever been in an emotionally or physically, oh, this is two-part, so, okay, so I'm, okay, let me do the first part. Then. No, I can do this together because this wraps into that. Have you ever been in an emotionally or physically abusive relationship? If so, how did you get out? Or if not, how would you do? Physically? No, because I would beat you down. I'm gay, so I'm with, you know, deal with women. So I don't, that's, you hit me, guess what? I'm gonna hit you back. Ha! Self-defense! Yeah, but I would never raise my hand to hit, no, I don't believe, that's dumb. I don't come from that, I don't know. But best belief. Girl! You just gotta hit me, because once you hit me, it's self-defense. Ha! What's the first one? Emotionally, yes. You know, I just came out of some bullshit. How did I get out of it? I finally left it. Yeah. Yeah, just bye. Girl, bye. But this has been the most I've ever... I thought that I've done dealt with some shit, but this has been the most toxic, emotionally abusive relationship. And going back to the previous question, going back above to something you asked me before... is thinking that it's too much thinking the right one and that the possibility later on, not looking at, bitch, do you see what the fuck is going on right now? The fuck? Where are we? Da-da-da-da. So I answered that two part. Number 8, if you fell in love long distance, would you move to them or want them to move to you? Ain't no moving going on, because in my younger days, I've tried long distance. Shit, it's hard to do the fucking within distance. I'm not adding that to the equation at this point in my life. Now, being that I'm looking to be out of New York 5 to 6 years from now, God spare my life. If I was to meet someone, you know, and yeah, that place would be open to possibility to me of me moving. But I'm not, honestly, me personally, I'm not moving. Okay, let me come back, because as I'm talking, I'm thinking. I don't want to move. No, at this point in my life, I have to say no. Because I'm not moving somewhere to be with somebody. Because what if that thing don't work out? I have to move to where I know I'm going to make life with myself, where I'm fine. Where with or without somebody, I love where the hell I'm at. So I ain't moving for no love. Now, if we here up in New York, well, the 5 boroughs, wherever, you understand? And we building something, and we decide we want to go out there, then we're making the plans to move. Sure, no thing. But it's vice versa. I don't want no one moving to me, and I don't want no... It ain't no. 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 Because my thing, you know... Nah, the person has to be independent and doing their thing. And New York, and again, if I was... Wherever that's using New York is where I am, and they saying they want to come to New York, but they coming to do get their own. Da-da. You ain't coming to move with me. I ain't... No. You make... I think you follow me. Yeah. No. 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 Do you ever think it's okay to lie to people you love? No. And people say, oh, this question's asked. This is my answer. It's my answer. Fuck what anybody else think. No, I don't think it is. No. No. For me, hey, what you say may hurt my feelings, but I'd rather know. Let's rip this Band-Aid off and deal with it than... I'm thinking one thing, then later on I find out something else. That's just gonna fuck this shit up a whole... Nah. Nah. I don't... For me, I can't speak... I'm speaking... Samantha, for me, no. If you love me, don't lie to me. Because I'm gonna find this shit out anyway. And that's just gonna piss me the fuck off. You see how... Yeah! Don't do it. Last question. What is one societal norm you'd redesign if you could? From my life, from my view, I gotta pick one. Without, is that a societal? Well, I don't know if it's, you know, again, speaking from the things that I've been thinking about, I don't know if it's a societal norm, but one, you know, off the top of my head, what I would change? Yeah, it is a social, I don't know. But I'm just gonna answer it how I wanna answer it. If I don't answer it, you can come back another question to help, you know, make it more precise that I do answer correctly. I would change all these, you know, all these different, what you call it, denominations of religion. I don't know if societal, no, I don't know if I'm taking to another, but I would change that. Yeah, I would change that. Yeah. Like, yeah. The battery cut off. I never record that longer clip. I was like, ooh, I'm glad I paid attention. It recorded like 10 minutes, I'm on a G7X, all right, whatever. But yeah, that's what I would change. there. This was fun, y'all. T. Smith, you be coming with it. You thought-provoking questions, and I appreciate you very much. I appreciate every member of this channel. Thank you for making videos like this possible. Y'all make sure y'all leave a comment, hit that thumbs up, and that's all I got for you, and I'm out.